Hi, good evening.
Hello.
Good evening, teacher. Hi, Mariela, how are you?
Fine.
¿Cómo siguió?
Ya me siento mejor, pero todavía no se me quita la tos.
Sí, ¿verdad? All right. Bueno, esperemos que siga mejorando. Oye.
Gracias.
Very good. Hi, Andrés Giovanni. Hi, Edgar. How are you? Hola, hola.
Hi, teacher. Good
Hi, Edgar.
evening.
Good evening.
Sorry.
That's
Ayer
okay.
no pude.
Sí, okay. Pero aquí estamos ya. Eso es bueno. Ya es la última
Ya.
semana, Edgar.
Esta es la última semana, ¿verdad? No.
La última
¿Cómo
semana,
no?
sí. Así es que ya
No.
tenemos que
¿Y
terminar.
cuándo termina? ¿Qué día termina
El
el
viernes,
curso?
el
El
viernes, Edgar,
viernes.
sí, el viernes. El viernes vamos a terminar y ayer le decía a
Okay.
los compañeros que es de tener toda la plataforma terminada, toda la sección 4 y el examen final para el viernes. Oye.
Okay.
All right, very good. A ver, let's see. Hi, Fabiola. How are you?
Okay. I'm fine.
Thank you. Very good to have you in class. And Andres Giovanni. Hello, Andres.
Hi, teacher.
Hi. Very good. Thank you for being in class with me tonight. We have 3 more days, guys. We're almost finishing. Okay, so that's very, very good. All right, so yesterday we were talking a little bit about hotels. We were talking about making a reservation, we were talking about amenities, we were talking about facilities, we were talking about services in a hotel, all right? And then you guys came up with a conversation. Today, we're going to continue talking a little bit about hotels, all right? Using that vocabulary, but we are also going to use, or we're going to learn how to use future with be going to, all right? So we're going to be studying future a little bit for this class. All right. And we, as I said yesterday, we are right on track with everything, with the topics and the section and everything. Okay. So we're going to wait a couple of more minutes to take my first attendance. All right. Usually I take it at 8:05 to give some time for your rest of your classmates to come to class. So let's see, Fabiola, do you remember one place? That we have in a hotel. Can you think of a place that we have in a hotel that you can have?
Reception.
The reception desk. Okay, very good. The reception. All right, very good. Okay. Mariela, any other place that you remember from the hotel?
Laundry service.
Ah, yeah, very good. The laundry, and then you have a laundry service. Very good. Excellent. All right, very nice. Andres, do you remember any other amenities or facilities or services that we have in a hotel?
Restaurant,
Restaurant,
bar,
bar, very good. The lounge, also, very good. All right. Elsie, welcome. Magali and Saul, welcome to class. And Francisco, and Juan Francisco, also. Very good. Let's see. Elcita, do you remember any other place or facility from a hotel that we can find?
yes, teacher, laundry service, valet
Yes,
parking.
valet parking. Very good.
Wi-Fi,
That's very important now. Okay.
shuttle, no, don't remember
Shuttle
pronunciation.
service.
Shuttle
The
service,
shuttle service, very good. All right, nice.
wake up call.
Very good. All right, the wake up call. Very good. Okay, so let's see. Saul, good evening. When you have an event, Saul, for
Good
example,
evening.
good evening, Saul. So when you have an event, for example, a Christmas party or a wedding, there is a special room in the hotel that they can celebrate. Do you remember what is the name of that place, Saul?
Place. Yes. Lobby, gym, restaurant,
parking,
all right,
in the center.
Okay, kitchen. Yeah, very good. The kitchen, right, very good. Very nice, Abu, thank you. All right, there is a place in a hotel donde usted celebra bodas o aniversarios o qué sé yo, fiestas, and it's called ballroom, all right? Así como tenemos el conference room or the business center, tenemos como los salones donde se hacen los eventos, they are ballrooms, okay? So those are like very, usually the hotels have, all right? Ayer igual decíamos que depende del hotel, si es grande, es pequeño, all right? Va a tener different services, but in different places, facilities, and stuff, all right? So that's what we talked about yesterday. Vamos a tomar la primera asistencia de la noche. Let's see, we have Andrés Giovanni Valdivieso Portillo.
Present, teacher.
Noemí Córdoba de Valencia.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Yamileto Osorio Alfaro. Candelaria del Tránsito Martínez Cisneros. Edgar Alfredo Mengíbar Pineda.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Carla Marta Cano Rivas.
Here.
Excellent. Very nice. Mayra Yasmín Rodríguez García. All right. Omar Ramírez Vázquez. Fabiola Georgina Silva.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Juan Francisco Enríquez González.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Elsie Anet de María Ramírez Navarro.
Present, teacher.
Marcos Giovanni Moran Flores. Not yet. Werner Mauricio Reyes Ángel. Not yet. All right. Jennifer Magali Morales Guzmán.
Present.
Oh, very good. Thank you, Magali. Carlos Jonathan García Alvarado. Jorge Antonio Hernández Cruz. Francisco Javier Aviatoro Canales. Mariela Ángeles Alvarado Díaz.
Present.
And Jose Saul Gonzalez Roque.
Present, teacher.
Perfect, thank you. All right, very good, guys. So today, as I told you, we're going to talk about be going to refer about future, all right? So that's what we're going to study today. We're going to go right now to the manual on page, let me see the page, on page 40. Yeah, this is the one that we saw yesterday. So yesterday we saw page 40. We're going to study page 41. Here, guys, remember that we have some of the pictures of hotel services and amenities, all right? So we have this. Remember that an amenity is the extra that hotel gives you, that extra service that the hotel can bring to you, all right? So depends on the hotel, depends where it is, depends how big it is. That will depend on the amenity they offer to you. Okay, now let's keep on talking about you. I will be able to. Let's see, Edgar, can you read this, please, Edgar? I will be able to.
Okay, I will be able to make a hotel reservation and request related service.
Related services, very good. Thank you, Edgar, very nice. So make a hotel reservation and request related services, okay? So that's what we're going to be able to do tonight, okay? We're going to talk about future. Obviamente el futuro no solo es para hacer reservaciones en hoteles. It's about anything that you need to do. But we're going to concentrate on how to make hotel reservations, okay? Travel plans. All right, so number one, do you prefer to stay in a modern or antique hotel when you travel, all right? Hay un micrófono abierto por aquí. All right, do you guys to stay in a big hotel or kind of like antique hotel? What do you like, what kind of hotels do you guys like to stay in? Anybody? Elsie, what kind of hotels do you prefer more? Modern or kind of like antique, like rustic kind of hotels?
Modern.
Modern, all right, very good. Fabi, what about you? If you have to go to a hotel, do you like to stay in a modern hotel or in an antique hotel?
Modern.
Modern, very good. All right, nice. Okay, let me see. Carla, what about you? When you have to travel anywhere, do you like to stay in a modern or more like an antique hotel?
Antique is okay.
Yeah, all right. Yeah, I agree with you too. Very good. All right. Do you guys usually make hotel reservations or someone else does it for you? When you need to travel, make your own reservations or someone else makes them for you? Mariela, do you make your own hotel reservations when you need to do it? Or someone else
Yes.
does it for you?
I do reservation for my partners.
Okay, all right, very good. So you're the one making the reservations, right? All right, interesting, very good. Okay, so here we have, guys, let's see. Listen to your teacher read the conversation, then practice with a partner a phone call to a hotel. So we have two people here. We have Jen and we have Gerardo. All right, so Jen says, hello, thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel. This is Jen, how can I help you? All right, this is very important, guys, because usually when you call a hotel or an office, this is how they're gonna say hello to you, all right? So hello, thank you for calling, and then the name of the business, or in this case, the hotel or the company, all right? This is Jen, and you give your name, like you give the name of the person that is helping you, okay? And then the question goes right away. How can I help you? All right, that is very, very important. So if you notice, you have the greeting, all right? You thank the person for calling the company, so you need the company's name along with thanking them. You introduce yourself and then you offer help. Okay, so that's like, those are the steps that you need to follow when you answer a call to help someone, all right? And Gerardo says, hello, I need to make a reservation. Sure, may I have your name, please? All right, no le pregunto a usted, what's your name? Eso no se oye como bien nice, all right? Siempre le diría, may I have your name, please? Or may I have your full name, please, all right? Of course, I'm Gerardo Gomez. Thank you, Mr. Gomez. When are you going to arrive? I'm going to arrive on Friday 14th. How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Gomez? I'm going to stay until Monday. Are you going to make the reservation for a single or a double room? A single room, please. Obviamente, la conversación goes on, all right? But this is pretty much what you need to do or what you need to know to make a reservation, all right? So that this information is very, very important. Okay, let's see. Saul, can you be Gerardo? And Magali, can you be Jen, please?
Hello. Thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel. This is Jen. How can I help you?
Hello, I need to make a reservation.
Sure, may I have your name, please?
Of course, I am Gerardo Gomez.
Thank you, Mr. Gomez. Where are you going to travel to arrive?
I am going to arrive on Friday 14th.
How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Gomez?
I am going to stay until Monday.
Are you going to make the reservation for a single or a double room?
A single room, please.
All right, very good. Thank you for that. Let's see. Edgar, you're going to be Gerardo. And Elcita, you're going to be Jen.
Okay.
Hello. Thank you for calling the Golden Star Hotel. This is Jen. How can I help you?
Hello. I need to make a reservation.
Sure. May I have your name, please?
Of course. I'm Gerardo Gomez.
Thank you, Mr. Gomez. When are you going to arrive?
I'm going to arrive on Friday 14th.
How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Gomez?
I'm going to stay until Monday.
Are you going to make the reservation for a single or a double room?
A single room, please.
Perfect. Very good, Edgar. Very good, Elsie. Okay, and two more volunteers. The last two volunteers to do this conversation. I need a Jen and I need a Gerardo. All right, two more. I'm not going to choose you. You can volunteer yourselves.
I'm Jen.
Okay, thank you. Who's going to be Gerardo? I need a Gerardo. Thank you.
Hello, thank you for calling the Walden Star Hotel. This is Jen. How can I help you?
Hello, I need to make a reservation.
Sure, may I have your name, please?
Of course, I'm Gerardo Gomez.
Thank you, Mr. Gomez. Where are you going to arrive?
I'm going to arrive on Friday 14th.
How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Gomez?
I'm going to stay until Monday.
Are you going to make a reservation for a single or a double room?
A single room, please.
Perfect. Very good. Thank you. All right, guys. Just make sure about the pronunciation. Is hotel, all right? That is the pronunciation for that word, hotel. It's not hotel, it's not hotel, it's hotel. All right, this is Jen, how can I help you? Tratemos de, la pregunta es como más de corrido. How can I help you? All right, so it sounds like more natural. How can I help you? All right, I need to make a reservation. All right, the reservation kind of thing, okay. May I have your name, please? Of course, I'm Gerardo. Thank you, Mr. Gomez. When are you going to arrive? All right. Cuidado con la fecha. I'm going to arrive on Friday 14th. All right. How long are you going to stay with us, Mr. Gomez? I'm going to stay until Monday. Hasta el lunes, until Monday. Are you going to make the reservation for a single or double room? Room, please. All right. Revise ahí el vocabulario de la conversación. Si hay algo que necesita que le aclare, or everything, it's okay. It's okay. Everything is okay.
¿Cuál es la diferencia entre going to and will?
Eso vamos a ver ahora, de hecho, Francisco Javier. Ya vamos a llegar a la gramática, que es lo que nos toca ver ahora. Thank you. Very good. ¿Alguien tenía otra pregunta?
Yo, teacher Noemí, pero era lo mismo. ¿Cuál era la diferencia? Porque en nuestra conversación nosotros ayer usamos will.
Claro. All right. Okay, entonces, ya lo vamos a ver. Okay, okay. Very good. Thank you, Francisco Javier. Very good. Aparte de esa estructura gramatical del futuro, que nos mencionan ambos compañeros, ¿alguien más tiene a question about these guys or not? No, we're okay.
Teacher, ¿cómo se pronuncia until? ¿Está bien así?
Yes, until Monday, yes.
Until.
Yeah.
Until Monday.
Very good, hasta lunes, very good, until Monday. All right, guys, so here, voy a dejar de compartir aquí, y solo déjeme buscar mi presentación. Para hablar de la diferencia de las dos usos. All right, guys, thank you for waiting. All right, very good. Thank you for waiting, guys, and I'm sorry for that. All right, so here, oops. Let me see here. This. Okay, so here we have. This is the presentation I have for you here. Remember, before I show it to you, remember that in English we have two ways of expressing, thank you, Luis, for expressing future, all right? We have, hay un micrófono abierto por ahí. We have will and we have be going to. Y nos preguntaba tanto Francisco como Noemi, ¿cuál es la diferencia? All right, what is the difference between these two ways of using future, all right? Usted quiere decir, I will go to, I don't know, I will go to the park on Sunday. Ahora es martes, usted va a ir el domingo. So you say, I will go to the beach on, I mean, to the park or whatever on Sunday. Perfectamente usted puede decir, I'm going to go to the beach on Sunday or to the park on Sunday, all right? Ambos me reflejan futuro, okay? Eso no queda de otra, all right? So I can use will and I can use going to, pero tienen sus diferencias, all right? Una de las grandes diferencias es will, a lo contrario de lo que nos han enseñado, porque en el colegio, en la escuela o en el instituto, cuando hablamos de futuro siempre nos enseñan el will primero, all right? De hecho, no sé si se les enseña el be going to, pero el will es como futuro, ¿ok? Sí, es futuro, pero cuando hablamos del will y lo usamos para cuando usted no está seguro o segura de que sucederá. For example, you say, I will go to the beach on Saturday, all right? Cuando yo ocupo el will, hay 50% de certeza de que yo voy a ir y 50% de no tan seguro que yo voy a ir. Entonces, eso es un 50-50, ¿ok? Entonces, cuando algo es como, así como decir, no estoy tan segura, pero iré, all right? Entonces, usamos el will. Cuando usted está casi, 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 que un 100% seguro, un 90 y más del 95%, y usted dice, I am going to go to the beach, all right, on Saturday, usted está casi seguro o segura que eso va a suceder, all right? Entonces, una de las grandes diferencias es eso. Uno, el will nos da duda, nos da así como que no estoy segura o no estoy seguro if I'm gonna go. Y la otra, el going to, sí nos da certeza de que yo voy, a menos que pase alguna emergencia, que eso nunca sabremos de antemano, all right? Pero usted está casi seguro o segura that that's going to happen. Esa es una diferencia entre el will y el going to. Otra diferencia es el hecho de tener algo planeado. I have a plan, all right? Si yo tengo algo planeado, desde ahorita yo digo, next Christmas, apenas estoy en febrero, pero ya me adelanté a Christmas, y digo, next Christmas, I am going to go to Antigua Guatemala. Ya tengo yo planeado algo, ¿ok? Entonces uso el going to. I'm going to go to Guatemala or Antigua Guatemala next Christmas. Y lo estoy planeando desde ahorita. Al contrario del will, el will lo ocupo para algo que no es planeado. Por ejemplo, yo les digo, who wants to read the conversation? Y Andrés Giovanni me dice, I will, teacher. Él no lo planeó, salió en el momento. Es una decisión que se toma in this moment, all right? So it's more spontaneous, okay? Entonces, ahí Andrés Giovanni dice, I'll read it, teacher. I will do it. Si estuviéramos en un salón de clase, yo le pregunto, who wants to write on the board? Y usted me dice, I will, teacher. Y usted pasa la pizarra y escribe. Usted no lo planeó. Usted no llegó, no iba manejando, no iba en el bus pensando, si la teacher pregunta, yo voy a ir a la pizarra. No lo planea. Sucede en el momento, all right? Cuando usted promete, usted dice, prometo terminar la plataforma, teacher, antes del viernes. All right? Usted va a decir, I will promise, or I promise, sorry, or I will do the platform, all right? Me está prometiendo que usted lo va a hacer. Entonces me dice, I will work on the platform for Friday, all right? Entonces, cuando promete, cuando es un evento no planeado y es más espontáneo, certeza no es tan certera, all right, no es tan cierta, entonces usamos el will, el be going to, y cuando digo be going to, ya vamos a ver la estructura, el be going to es porque voy a usar el verbo to be plus going to plus the verb. Entonces digo, I am going to go, I am going to take, puede ser cualquier verbo, usted puede poner en futuro cualquier verbo, all right, no solamente el go, ¿verdad? O el we, o el it, cualquiera. Cuando usted está seguro de que va a pasar, cuando usted haya hecho un plan, ya está dentro de un plan que eso va a suceder, all right, usted va a ocupar el be going to. Entonces, esos son como los más, la diferencia más grande between will and be going to. Hay más, all right, hay más, pero nos tienden a confundir. Entonces, con estos que les acabo de decir, creo que es más que suficiente para que usted pueda decir, ah, bueno, si usted ve al cielo, si hubiera visto el cielo y ve aquello todo gris y de repente hasta relámpago ya casi entrando la noche, pues lo más seguro es que vaya a llover. Entonces dice usted, oh, oh, me voy a mojar. I'm going to get wet because it will rain. All right, because it's going to rain. Entonces cuando hay algo que usted le da la pauta que va a suceder, es be going to. All right. Entonces esa es como las grandes diferencias entre el will y el going to. Do you have any questions hasta ahorita about that, guys? Any questions about that?
Okay. Déjame ver si entendí claro el asunto.
Ajá.
Si tenemos una situación donde hay mucha probabilidad de que va a ocurrir, yo estoy planificando que, okay, yo digo, vamos a ir a la playa el próximo domingo, ¿ok? Y está ahí ya, está planeado de esa manera.
Sí.
Ok, pero pueda que no, ¿no? Pero ¿qué tal si, sí, si digo igual, we are going to the beach next Sunday?
Uh-huh.
O sea...
Se le apagó el micrófono.
Uh-huh. Ya. La diferencia sería básicamente en que yo tengo una certeza de que voy a ir.
Sí. Yep.
Independientemente del momento, el tiempo.
Sí.
Siempre que sea futuro.
Sí. Pretty much. Entonces, usted, Francisco Javier, ya planeó, ya lo planeó con su familia y usted está, ya compró la hielera y la carne y no sé qué, que van a hacer una gran barbecue en the beach. Entonces usted dice, I'm going to go on Sunday, o Saturday, o el día que vaya a ir. Porque ya lo tiene planeado y usted está casi 100% seguro que va a suceder. Obviamente puede pasar una emergencia, pero usted no sabe si va a pasar una emergencia. All right? Entonces ahí la situación va a cambiar, pero en lo contrario usted dice, yeah, I'm going to go to the beach on Saturday with my family. All right?
Ok, pero en el caso de que esté esta situación y pues que, ¿cómo lo entiende la otra persona? Porque yo estoy diciendo que voy a ir el próximo domingo a la playa.
Sí.
Ok, y es una certeza para mí.
Sí.
Pero la otra persona queda en la situación, puede ser cierto, puede ser mentira, dependiendo no. De si uso el going
exacto.
To
exactamente.
O el will.
Exacto. Si usted a mí viene y me dice, Jessica, fíjese que I'm going to go to the beach on Sunday, yo le digo, really, qué chivo. O sea, yo el domingo pienso en que lo que usted me comentó y digo, qué chivo, Francisco Javier anda por la playa, porque usted me dijo, I'm going to go. All right? Si usted me hubiese dicho, I will go to the beach on Sunday, yo el domingo pienso, a saber si habrá ido. All right? Pudo haber ido como pudo que no, porque no me estaba dando una certeza del casi 100%.
Okay, entonces, ¿y qué tal? Perdón. ¿Y qué tal si esta situación se usa con el verbo intentar? Por ejemplo, I will try to qué sé yo, ir a la playa, ¿no?
Uh-huh.
Okay, y o si digo I'm going to
try to go.
I will I'm going to try go to the beach.
Ajá. Uh-huh. Igual,
yeah.
Usted me está dando la certeza, aunque me está diciendo intentaré ir, all right, uh-huh. Dentro de esa no certeza, me está dando la certeza que usted intentará. All right.
Okay.
Mientras que usted me dice, I will try, es menos probable todavía que me diga solo I will go.
Yeah. Okay.
¿Verdad? Entonces ahí va a depender de cómo lo dice usted y así lo recibo yo. Si usted me dice, I'm going to, es como que usted, por decirle, I'm going to finish the platform, yo sé que usted, o estoy casi segura que usted, usted terminará la plataforma, por decirle, el jueves. All right? Pero usted me dice, I will finish, teacher. Ya me queda la duda. All right, that you will finish the platform or not. Okay? Entonces, así lo dice usted. Ese es el mensaje que usted me transmite a mí, dependiendo si ocupa el going to, be going to, o el will. All right?
Okay, es un mensaje de doble vía, entonces.
Sí,
uno para convencer y otro para estar convencido.
Exacto, exacto. Sí, sí. Ajá. All right, entonces usted me dice, I'm going to, y luego el verbo, yo estoy dando casi que afirmando o estoy creyendo en usted y que usted me está diciendo que usted va a ir o que usted va a terminar o que usted va a comer o qué sé yo. All right, independientemente el verbo que usted use o la acción que usted está poniendo en futuro, yo le creo que está, que eso va a suceder. All right, okay, very good. Thank you, Francisco. I don't know if you guys have any other question about that. No more questions. Elcita, you understand? Carla, yes. Mariela, Werner, ¿ya?
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. All right, very good. Now, I'm going to...
Aunque, en esa, en lo que estaba diciendo Francisco,
uh-huh.
o sea, teacher, quiere decir que no es lo mismo decir yo pienso, o sea, pensar como que pueda ser la probabilidad que usted se acuerda de unos verbos como de probabilidad que había, si había, ajá, un 10%, un 20%, ¿sí? Este sería algo parecido, o sea, el decir yo pienso al decir yo voy a hacer, o sea, algo planeado, sí, o algo que, uh-huh, que no se sabe si va a suceder o, exacto, pienso hacer.
Claro.
En este caso, ajá, o sea, digamos, como lo que dijo, yo pienso ir, no es lo mismo decir yo pienso ir a la playa el fin de semana a decir yo voy a ir a la playa el fin de semana.
Uh-huh, uh-huh. Pretty much, Werner. Yeah.
Okay, teacher. Right. Okay. Very good.
Ahora, es importante, y eso se lo voy a recalcar ahorita que lo vamos a ver en estructura, es importante que el verbo be no se omita cuando ocupamos el going to. La regla o la estructura es be plus going to plus verb. Okay? Ojo, no se me confunda con el verbo con el presente progresivo o con el presente continuo. El presente continuo es I'm going home. Ese es presente continuo. All right? Si usted me dice I'm going to go home, ese es futuro con el be going to. All right? ¿Me entiende la diferencia? Yo digo I'm going home. Ese es presente continuo normal. Pero si yo digo I'm going to go home, ese es futuro con el be going to. Es más largo. All right? Y la estructura es be plus going to más X. Puede ser go, puede ser fix, puede ser comer, puede ser bailar, puede ser cocinar, puede ser escribir, leer, cantar, el que usted quiera. All right? Pero después del going to va a ir ese verbo en su forma base. Okay? Pero el verbo to be es súper importante que se pronuncie y se escriba. Por lo general nos lo comemos cuando... o lo omitimos cuando hablamos, cuando lo estamos aprendiendo. Y decimos, I'm going to go. Está mal dicho. I'm going to go. He's going to plan. She's going to study. All right? They're going to play. We are going to study. ¿Sí? Entonces, el verbo be, obviamente, va a depender del sujeto del que estamos hablando. Si estoy hablando de I, obviamente es am. Si estoy hablando de he, she, it, es is. If I'm talking about you, we, they, are, I mean you, we, they, are. All right? Entonces jugamos con ese verbo be. Y luego el going to es igual para todos. All right? So yo digo, Andrés.
¿Puede, perdón?
Sí, sí, sí.
Tal y como estaba mencionando, o sea, el verbo to be, la forma going to y el, ¿qué es la?
El verbo base.
Ajá, uh-huh. Exacto. ¿Sí se puede?
¿Sí?
Como decir, they are going to play soccer.
Sure, yeah. Yeah, you can say that. De hecho, así tendría que ser, ¿verdad? Si usted omite el are, ya está malo. Si usted solo dice, they going to play soccer, está estructuralmente y gramaticalmente mal. They are, all right? Y si usted dice, they are playing soccer, está malo porque no me está usando el futuro, me está usando el presente continuo. They are playing soccer ahorita, in this moment. Ah, eso es diferente. They are going to play soccer, no están jugando ahorita, van a jugar, ya sea a las 10 de la noche o mañana o el otro año. That's future. Right? Entonces la estructura es completa, all right? The, plus going to plus verb. All right? De lo contrario nos jugaríamos con el presente continuo aquí. ¿Okay?
¿Qué pasaba? Perdón, un poco preguntón he venido ahora.
No, es okay, Francisco, es okay.
¿Qué pasaba con la situación de la parte 4 del ejercicio del,
no,
del examen
no,
17?
No, eso me del examen 17, eso me decía Andrés Giovanni, no se cambió Andrés. No, ¿verdad?
No.
All right.
Sí, no funcionó.
Sé. No funcionó.
Quizás un problema en la plataforma, ¿por qué no?
No, el mío sí funcionó.
Sí, lo sí funcionó, Francisco.
Sí, sí.
Okay.
You are going to.
Solo puso are going to. No,
pero sí, lo sí mismo puse, no.
Sí, Andrés Giovanni me mandó captura que él no le, se le había cambiado. ¿Le dio refrescar a la página, Andrés Giovanni, antes de hacerlo?
Voy a intentar ahorita.
Ajá, inténtelo. Lo que pasa, Francisco, que cuando se puso la respuesta tenía una letra de más. All right, entonces por eso no se la agarraba. Estaba poniendo bien desde el principio. Entonces cuando yo la revisé, eliminé la letra que estaba de más y ya la tendría que agarrar. Y a usted le funcionó, Francisco. Sí, ¿verdad?
Sí, 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 all solo right, con right, el refresco de la página.
Ajá. All right, very good. Okay, so hoy les voy a enseñar esto. This is what I wanted to show you. All right, so here, girls and guys, okay? So simple future has two different forms in English, will and going to. Eso siempre lo vamos a ver. Usted ve will y dice eso es futuro. Usted be going to y eso es futuro. Eso lo tiene que entender nomás lo vea, okay? Now, vamos a ir aquí, a ver. The structure of the simple future tense, el subject, el will, y el main verb, or the base verb. Cuando decimos V1 es el verbo base. Quiere decir que will es para todos. I will, you will, they will, he will, she will, we will, Edgar, Viola will, Werner, and I will, Mariela will, no importa de qué sujeto hable, el will no cambia. All right? Entonces el futuro es bien fácil. El solo agrega el will y usted ya se fue al futuro. All right? El siguiente verbo, que es cualquier verbo que usted quiera poner en futuro, pues es en su forma base. Aunque yo esté hablando de Fabiola, yo digo Fabiola will sleep at 11 p.m., sleep ya no me cambia. ¿Por qué? Porque llevo el will. Entonces no me va a cambiar nada. Yo voy a decir I will sleep, como voy a decir Edgar will sleep, como voy a decir Saúl and Elsie will study. No importa. Will no cambia y el verbo va a ser tampoco para nadie. Entonces eso es bien fácil. All right? A ver aquí. Si se fija, I will open the door. I will. O decimos you will finish before me. No cambió ni el will, ni cambió el verbo para nada, ¿verdad? No lleva ningún cambio, no lleva ninguna inflexión ahí. El will es el mismo. Cuando usted quiere hacer una oración en negativo, cuando usted dice, yo no dormiré a las 11, yo dormiré a las 12. All right, usted dice, she will not be at school tomorrow. O dice, we will not leave yet. All right, no nos iremos todavía. Ella no irá o no estará en la escuela mañana. ¿Ok? Ese es not. Usted le pone el not entre medio del will y el verbo base. ¿Ok? Abusamos mucho la contracción de won't. She won't be at school tomorrow. Unimos el will plus el not. Hacemos una sola y decimos won't. ¿Ok? Y si le cuesta, diga will not. No hay problema. When it's question, igual que todo lo tratamos de igual forma, permítame que voy a... Cuando es question, we have will, y luego el sujeto, will you arrive on time? Will they want dinner? All right, solo le doy vuelta al will con el sujeto o el pronombre y lo demás me queda igual. Obviamente, si lo escribo, pongo signo de interrogación. Will you arrive on time? Will they want dinner? Will they brush their teeth? All right, so this is how we do it. All right, Viendo ya este cuadrito acá, do you guys have any questions or no? ¿Estamos bien hasta ahorita? Okay. Yeah. All right. Let's continue. All right. Si usted lo que, si se fija, aquí está la fórmula o la estructura completa. I will open the door. En este está la forma contractada. Al, whatever. You, y el verbo que sigue. He'll, she'll, ill, will, and they'll. All right. So you say I'll go. Ya no dice I will go, si dice algo, all right? Or you say, you'll do this tomorrow, all right? Or he'll buy a newspaper, she'll work for me, all right? So esta es la forma que usted hace para la contracción. En el caso que fuese negativo, usted le pone el not aquí, you'll not, y el verbo que le sigue, all right? Ahora, eso es lo que estamos ahorita enfocados, que es el be going to. Cuando acuérdese que decimos be going to, no es que va a usar el be como tal, lo va a desglosar cuando lo conjugue dependiendo del sujeto. So, am, is, or are, plus going to, plus verb. You are going to meet Jane tonight. Are, si fuese pregunta, are you going to meet Jane tonight? You are not going to meet Jane tonight. This guy's here. Right, this is affirmative, this is question, and this, I mean, yeah, this is affirmative, this is question, and this is negative. All right, ¿dónde colocamos el not? Entre medio del verbo be y el going to. Okay, el going to va a quedar igual para todo, así como el will lo usamos para todos los pronombres, I will, you will, they will, she will, el going to es igual. Lo que va a cambiar es el verbo be. De lo contrario, nada más cambia. I am going to study. She is going to study. They are going to study. We are going to study. She is going to study. El going to y el verbo base es igual. Lo que va a cambiar es el verbo be, nada más. Right? Y usted está haciendo una oración en future. Si fuese afirmativa, si fuese pregunta, solo le agrega el not. Y si fuese pregunta, solo antepone el verbo be ante el pronombre sujeto y ya formó su pregunta en futuro. ¿Ok? Ahora, ¿cómo contesto? Si yo le digo, a ver, Elsie, si yo le digo, are you going to finish? Y usted dígame que sí. Are you going to finish the platform tonight, Elcita? ¿Cómo me contestaría?
Yes. Uh-huh. Yes, you are.
Casi, pero la pregunta se la hago yo a usted. Yo le digo, Elsie, are you going to finish the platform tonight? ¿Cómo me contesta, Elsie? Yes. ¿Quién va a terminar? Yes. ¿Usted o yo?
Yes, I finish.
Casi, ya vamos, ya llegamos, Elcita. Yes, I, hasta ahí va bien. Yes, I can.
Yes, I am.
Excellent, yes, I am. Very good, yes, I am.
Yes, all I right? am, finish.
No se complique, yes, I am. All right, yo le pregunto, Edgar, le pregunto a usted sobre Saúl. Is Saúl going to play basketball on Sunday? Y contésteme que sí. Is Saul going to play basketball on Sunday?
Yes, he is.
Excellent. Yes, he is. Hasta ahí se queda. All right, very good. A ver, Mariela, are Werner and Carla going to eat hamburgers?
yes, they are.
Thank you. Very good. Nice. All right. Juan Francisco, I say, Juan Francisco, listen to my question. Am I going to be your teacher for next course? No sabemos, pero igual. Uh-huh. Am I going to be your teacher for next course? Usted dígame que sí, solo por cuestiones de práctica.
Repeat, teacher, please.
Yes. Am I going to be your teacher? Am I going to be your teacher next course? ¿Quién me ayuda con esa? Ayudémosle a Juan Francisco ahí.
Yes, we are.
No, el yes lo tiene bien.
Yes, you are.
Yes, you are. All right, porque yo, es como que yo le pregunto a usted, como que usted supiera, ¿verdad? Y le pregunto, ¿iré a ser yo su maestra al otro curso? Y usted me dice, sí, yes, you are. All right, very good. Ahora, Andrés Giovanni, if I ask you and then any question and you're going to give me a negative answer, Andrés Giovanni, all right, I'm going to say, is Fabi going to go to Citalá next weekend? In negative?
No, she isn't.
No, she isn't. Very good. All right, nice. Okay, let's see. Werner. Is Magali and Noemi, sorry, are Magali and Noemi going to make pupusas? In negative, Werner,
Not, ¿cómo sería?
Are Magali and Noemi, creo que dije, are Magali and Noemi going to make pupusas? Se está incluyendo ahí, Werner.
We somos nosotros, but they say entonces.
Ah, very good. No, they. Acuérdense que es respuesta corta, Werner. No se complique. No, they. Oiga la pregunta, a ver. Are Magali and Noemi, o are they, ¿verdad? Are they going to make pupusas? No.
No, they are, teacher.
Ajá, no, they are, ¿qué? No, they are. Una palabrita le falta, una negación. No, they are.
Meat.
Not. No, they are
not. They are not. They are not.
Very good.
I remember, yeah.
Excellent, very good. So, no, they are not. Oh, usted puede decir, no, they aren't. Okay, es lo mismo. All right? Very good, Werner. Hasta ahorita, do we have any questions? Any questions? No questions, guys? No? ¿Estamos bien? All right. A ver, si se fija aquí, el be going to lo ocupamos para expresar un plan. To express a plan. Be going to expresses, pueden ver, ¿verdad? Can you guys see?
Yes.
Excellent. Yeah. Thank you. All right. So here we have be going to express or expresses that something is a plan. It expresses the idea that a person intends to do something in the future. It does not matter whether the plan is realistic or not. Mientras sea un plan, all right, you use be going to. Okay? Let me see here. A ver, Elsie, can you read the example number one, please?
He is going to spend his vacation in Hawaii.
Perfect. Juan Francisco, this one?
She is not going to spend her vacation in Hawaii.
Very good. Giovanni, can you do letter A and I will do letter B?
Pronunciation, teacher.
For letter A, lea la parte A y yo leo la parte B.
Okay, when are we going to meet each other tonight?
We are going to meet at 6 p.m. All right, very good, thank you. Then we have Fabi. What about Michelle? This, sorry. Aquí, this one, Fabi.
I'm going to be a doctor when I get up.
Excellent, very good. Werner, can you read this one, Michelle?
Michelle is going to begin medical school next year.
Michelle is going to begin medical school next year. Very good. Edgar, can you read this one, Day?
They are going to try all the way to Alaska.
Excellent, very good. Carla, can you read this one, please? Carlita?
Sorry, teacher, who are you going to invite to the party?
Very good, all right, let's see. Francisco Javier, can you be letter A and I will be letter B?
Okay. Who is going to make John's burger cake? So it's going to make John's burger cake.
Excellent. Very good. All right. Nice. Thank you. All right. Let me see this. Okay. I'm going to stop sharing this right now. Okay, guys. Do you have any questions about the future? En este caso nos estamos concentrando un poco más en el be going to. Sin embargo, también es como recordarles o hacerles ver la diferencia entre el will y el going to para que ustedes lo sepan desde ya, all right? O que se recuerden, porque creo que algunos ya lo sabían. Any questions about this or no questions? No? All right, perfect, very good. Okay, let's see. A ver, todos piensen en una pregunta usando el be going to. All right, usted no va a saber a quién le va a preguntar. So just think about it, all right? Le doy un minuto para pensar su pregunta. Escríbala, póngala por ahí. All right, and then you're gonna ask, okay? Solo la pregunta, no la respuesta. Only the question, using be going to. No con will, con el be going to. All right, finish with your question. Yeah. Excellent. All right, let's see. Mariela, can you ask Carlita, please?
Are you going to cook now?
Are you going to cook now?
Uh-huh, no, Carla? I'm not.
All right, very good. I thank you, Mariela. Very good. Carla, can you ask Edgar, Alfredo, please?
Edgar, are you going to have a picnic?
When, Carla? Are you going to have a picnic when?
The next Friday.
Okay, are you going to have a picnic next Friday, yes, Edgar?
Yes, I will.
Yes, I am?
Yes, I am, sorry.
Yes, I am. No, that's okay, Edgar. Very good. Thank you, Carla. Very good. Edgar, can you ask Noe, please? Noemi.
Noe, are you going to meet Noe tonight?
No, I'm not.
Another Noe. All right, that's okay. Very good. Thank you. All right, Noemi, can you ask Magali, please?
Magali. Okay. Are you going to dance the next Saturday?
Yes, I am.
Yes, I am. Very good. Yes, I am. Nice. Okay. Let me see. Magali asks Juan Francisco.
Juan Francisco, are you going to the cinema on Friday's night?
Very nice.
No, I am not.
Okay, very good, Juan Francisco. Can you ask Mariela, please?
Okay, Mariela, are you going to work tomorrow?
No, I'm not.
Really, Mariela?
Yes, I'm sick. I'm incapacitated 3 days.
Yes, very good. Good. All right, yeah, I remember that. Very good. All right, let's see. Saul, can you ask Kelsey, please?
They are going to drive all the way to Guatemala.
Are they going to drive all the way to Guatemala, Elsie?
No, they are not.
Okay, very good. No, they're not. Elcita, can you ask Francisco Javier?
Are you going to eat at the restaurant on Saturday?
No, I'm not.
Okay, very good. Francisco Javier, can you ask Andres Giovanni?
Okay. Andres Giovanni, are you going to visit Alaska next week?
Oh, cool. Oh, my goodness. All right.
No, I'm not.
Oh, come on, Andres. Let's go to Alaska. Very good. Andres Giovanni, ask Fabiola.
Say Alaska.
Yeah.
Are you going to have a page on this month?
Fabi? Are you going to have a page? Oh, cool. Very nice. Very good. All right. Fabi, can you ask Werner?
Are you going to play soccer tomorrow?
Are you going to play soccer tomorrow, Werner?
Yes, I am.
All right, very good. Yes, you are. Very good. Werner, Werner, lo veo doble. Werner, let's see.
Tengo la cámara en la
Yeah, I know. All right, Werner, ask me.
Are you going to fencing class, teacher?
No, I'm not. No, I'm not, Werner. I'm sorry. Are you going to go to fencing class? No, I'm not. All right, very good. All right, very nice, guys. Vamos a tomar la asistencia de la segunda parte y luego vamos a ver. Andrés Giovanni Valdivieso Portillo. Giovanni. Andrés Giovanni Valdivieso Portillo.
Presente.
Thank you. Soy la Noemí Córdoba de Valencia.
Presente.
Thank you. Yamilet Osorio Alfaro. Candelaria del Tránsito Martínez Cisneros. Edgar Alfredo Mengíbar Pineda.
Present teacher.
Carla Marta Cano Rivas.
Here.
Mayra Yasmín Rodríguez García. Omar Ramírez Vázquez. Fabiola Georgina Silva.
Present teacher.
Thank you. Juan Francisco Enríquez González.
Present teacher.
Elsie Anet de María Ramírez Navarro.
Present teacher.
Marcos Joran Flores, Werner Mauricio Reyes Ángel.
Present teacher.
Jennifer Magali Morales Guzmán.
Present.
Carlos Jonathan García Alvarado, Jorge Antonio Hernández Cruz. Francisco Javier Villatoro Canales.
Here.
Mariela Los Ángeles Alvarado Díaz.
Present.
And José Saúl González Roque.
Present teacher.
All right, very good, guys. So just let me get this for you here. All right, solo déjeme ver una cosa aquí, please. Okay. So we're gonna do this. There are two activities that I want you to do, that I want you to take a picture, all right? And then you guys are going to tell me the answers after that. Let me just wait so you can take a picture. fix it. Okay. Let's see here. There are only 6 questions, and then we can continue with the rest, okay?
So let me teacher. Just...
Hola. Tell me.
Y en este preciso momento, digamos, se me ocurrió algo ahí, ¿no? Si yo decimos, si decimos, we will going to take a picture. Y si decimos por el contrario, we will take a picture, ¿ya?
Ajá.
O sea, y vamos a hacer la misma cuestión. Pero ¿sí? La probabilidad la vamos a hacer ahorita.
Sí.
Entonces, o sea, cuando está en forma de pregunta, y es, de la misma manera, siempre está ese porcentaje.
Sí, o sea, la verdad que el uso del will siempre va a ser menos certero que el going to, que el be going
siempre,
to.
Siempre,
siempre.
Independientemente, mm-hmm. pregunta o lo que sea.
Mm-hmm. Pretty much.
Okay.
All right, very good. Okay, so here, guys, I want you to take a picture of this. Son dos fotos las que van a tomar ahorita. I want you to take a picture of this one right now. Wait. Okay, take a picture of this, please. Finished?
Yeah.
And take a picture of this. Okay. Ahora, ¿qué van a hacer en la primera foto? ¿Puedo moverla? Guys, can I move it? Yes, no? Okay, thank you. All right.
Yes.
So, thank you. All right, here we have 10 pictures, okay? I want you, ustedes va a escoger con su compañero o compañera cuáles van a ser positivas, cuáles van a ser negativas y cuáles van a ser preguntas. Lo que yo quiero es que sean 3 afirmativas, 3 negativas y 4 preguntas. ¿Cuáles va a escoger usted? Doesn't matter, usted decide, all right? 3 affirmative, 3 negative and 4 questions, okay? Using be going to, all right? Trate de hacer las oraciones así como completas, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, si está en la número 3, dice, he or my brother is going to swim next weekend on Lago de Coatepeque. So it's a whole sentence. Nada, no quiero nada más oraciones como, he is going to swim. Eso es como que ya está muy fácil, all right? So, más completa la información, all right? Así la positiva, así la pregunta. Si usted quiere la pregunta, puede ser con WH question, where, what, when, why, lo que usted quiera WH question para que no sea nada más, are you going to eat pizza? No, eso está muy fácil. All right, which pizza are you going to have next weekend? Está como un poco más hecha la pregunta, all right. Y la otra aquí, usted le va a preguntar a su compañero o compañera las preguntas. Entonces, yo estoy trabajando con Magali. Magali, I will say, okay, Magali, what time are you going to go to bed tonight? Y Magali es el turno de Magali que me conteste. Yo le hago las 6 preguntas a Magali, termina Magali y luego Magali me pregunta a mí. ¿Ok? Esas no necesariamente las tiene que escribir, es más, like, practice orally. ¿Ok? All right, guys? You understand? Ok, vamos entonces a los grupos acá. Hola, Francisco. Hola, Francisco. ¿Sí?
Me repite.
Three positive, 3 negative, 4 questions. Okay?
Thank you.
You're welcome. All right, so let's go to the groups right now, guys. Let me see. Okay.
No me puedo unir al grupo, teacher.
¿Qué le pasó, Mariela?
No sé, no me pude unir. Me sacó.
Okay. y le costaría mucho salirse de la reunión y volver a entrar para no, porque si no queda cita.
Vaya, ahorita. Vaya. Entonces.
Thank you. Hi, Elsie.
Hi, teacher. ¿Qué estaba diciendo? Estoy sola y usted apareció.
Lo que pasa es que Mariela iba a estar con usted, pero no le apareció la invitación. Entonces se salió y está tratando de volver a entrar.
Ah, ok, ok.
Pero para mientras, hagámoslo. Yo le ayudo, Elsita.
Vaya, ok. Espérenme, voy a ir a ver las fotos.
Vaya.
Con las figuritas vamos a hacer tres oraciones.
Three affirmative, three negative, and four questions, Elsie.
De las que queramos.
Sí, ustedes.
O sea, de la... Ah, ok. Es por ejemplo, quiero ver. Pero no las quiero sencillas, dijo.
Oh, ya no, Elsita.
Veamos. They are solo con going, ¿verdad?
Sí, going to.
They are going.
Ahorita están tratando, intentando Mariela de entrar.
Ahí está.
Ay, ay. Mm-hmm. All right.
Hi.
Hi, Mariela.
Hi. ¿Cómo sigue Mariela?
Ah, pues me siento mejor.
Ya se escucha mejor.
No se me, ajá. No se me quita la tos todavía. Eso me molesta bastante.
Sí. Iba a empezar, Mariela, ya con la primera oración. Ajá. Y como ahí veo un despertador, iba a poner they are going to wake up. They are going to wake up. No sé cómo armarlo.
Lo había puesto una con el despertador también.
¿Y qué había puesto?
Yo había puesto, what time are you going to the meeting? ¿A qué hora vamos a la reunión?
Ok. Bueno, podría poner yo esa de to wake up tomorrow.
Puede poner la hora, Elsita.
Ah, ok. They are going to wake up 7 a.m. Ah, o they are going to wake up tomorrow
at
7 a.m. Perdón, at 7 a.m.
At 7 a.m. Igual, la pregunta de Mariela estaba bien hecha también, ¿verdad? Pueden poner las dos, sí. o cada una, en ese caso que la hicieron separada, pero it's okay, both of them are okay.
La suya puso, Mariela, what time?
What time are you going to the meeting?
Are you going
to Solo the que meeting? Ahí, Mariela, le hace falta un verbo.
Ah,
What time are you going to? To organize, to what?
Entonces podría ser, what time are you going to? Are you going to?
No sé. Are you going to?
Puede ser asistir, planear, organizar, hacer.
What time are you going to plan?
To plan? What time are you going to plan the meeting? Uh-huh. You say, I'm going to plan the meeting at, I don't know, 8:30 in the morning. El caso que fuese contestada, ¿verdad?
Okay. Entonces, what time are you going to plan the meeting?
What time are you going to plan the meeting? I'm going to plan the meeting at 7 a.m.
Sure, yeah, okay.
Okay. La suya, ¿cuál era?
Que después de la
ahorita. Perdón, teacher.
Solo siempre recuérdense de que después del el going to,
ya tiene que ir otro verbo. La mía era, they are going to wake up tomorrow at 7 a.m.
They are going to wake up tomorrow
at 7 a.m.
Esa era pregunta también.
Sí.
No, Elcita, esa es una oración afirmativa, Elcita.
Ah, sí, perdón, perdón, perdón. Sí, nos pregunto.
¿Cuál otra podemos hacer?
Y tenemos que hacer una negativa también.
Acuérdense que son tres afirmativas, tres negativas y cuatro
preguntas. Ah, pues tenemos una afirmativa, una pregunta. O sea.
Ajá.
Vaya, entonces
sí, porque son 10 dibujitos.
No está bien.
Vaya, entonces, seguimos con las preguntas.
Ajá, si quieren, mejor. Vaya. Y después hacemos las afirmativas y por último las negativas. What time are you going to play in the meeting? Podríamos poner. Salud.
Y vamos a analizar 32, 34, algo así.
¿Y eso qué es?
28. Estaba con Javier y te lo puedo generar. Quedando el macho. Para mí.
Que no me haga nada, que por qué.
Podríamos hacerle el café.
Ay, no, yo ni estoy viendo la figurita. La del café podríamos poner y si ponemos cuándo iremos a tomar el café. When. ¿Para qué usan?
When going to.
No se les olvide el verbo be, no lo escucho ahí.
Es cierto. When are you?
When are we going to
comiéndonos toda la
drink. When are we going to drink? A cup of coffee.
Coffee.
Vaya, ahora la del swim.
Swim. Sería. When are we going to drink a cup?
Sería to swim o sería to swimming?
Swim. To swim.
To swim, porque es el verbo base, Mariela.
Okay. Bye. Entonces sería, where are you going to swim this week?
When are you going to swim next week? Dijo.
Puede ser this o next week o this week.
Ah, sí, porque esta semana o la próxima semana, vean.
Ajá.
Dejemos this
¿Cuál
week.
¿Cuál le ponemos?
This week.
Vaya. This week. Y pongamos la número 4 es comida, ¿verdad?
Quiero ver. Sí. Como cereales.
Puede
como
ser.
Para un desayuno.
What are you going to breakfast?
Eat. Porque no falta el verbo to eat. What are you going to eat breakfast?
Eat breakfast. Hasta ahí, ¿verdad? Podría ser. Where are you going to eat the breakfast? Vaya. Ahora, ¿cuántas? Una, dos, tres, cuatro. Uy, hicimos cinco preguntas.
No, cuatro.
Una,
cuatro es que la otra es una afirmativa. Ahora hagamos las otras afirmativas.
Vaya. Las otras las podemos hacer con esta de la computadora. La computadora.
Pero podemos poner she's going to learn. Ah, okay, learn.
No work está bien.
No, pero es mejor creo que bueno, work, vea. She's going to work.
She's going to work.
In the computer.
Blackie.
Sí.
Sácalo, mi
computer. In the computer today.
Perdón.
In the computer today o hasta el computer lo dejamos.
She's going to work in the computer tomorrow. Mejor tomorrow.
Vaya.
Ah, ya pusimos una de tomorrow, ve. Bueno, no importa. No importa, sí.
Vaya, ahora va la de la tienda de libros.
Ajá. Ahí podemos.
Hagámosle un nombre.
Laura.
Laura.
Is going to. Ahí sí podemos. Ajá, pero podríamos poner. No, tendríamos que poner el verbo. Laura is going to
learn.
Ajá, to learn.
To learn.
Laura is going to learn.
No, podemos poner mejor to buy. Laura is going to buy.
Ajá, to buy.
In the bookstore.
In the bookstore.
¿Cuántas eran de las afirmativas? Eran cuatro también, ¿no, verdad?
Sí, cuatro y cuatro, ¿verdad, teacher?
Tres afirmativas. Tres negativas and four questions.
Pues ya tenemos las afirmativas.
Sí. Ahora hasta nos pasamos. Tenemos cuatro.
No, solo quiero ver.
La que yo hice sola. They are going to wake up tomorrow.
Pero son tres.
Ah, es cierto, tiene razón. Esta es de las preguntas.
Ahora vamos con las negatives. Es un perrito este.
Ahorita veo. Sí. Ah, podríamos poner que no vamos a sacar a pasear el perro.
Entonces pondremos. We aren't going to go. We aren't going to go.
Ajá, y pasear, ¿cómo se dice?
No sé.
Pasear. We are not going to take the dog for a walk. We aren't going to take the dog for a walk. Como pasear.
Yeah. Dog for a walk.
W-O-K.
W-A-L-K, like caminar.
Ah, sí.
La otra es de unos niños.
¿Qué podríamos poner de los niños? They aren't or they are not. They are not going
to.
Is René going to play?
Going to sí.
With his pet. Perfecto.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow
in the park.
Tomorrow in the park.
Vamos a ver si.
Dos. ¿Podría? Ah, bueno, entonces ¿cómo quedó la uno?
Ahí solo le voy a deber el signo de interrogación. Así vea el chat.
Is René going to play with his pet?
Ajá, tomorrow in the park.
Tomorrow in the park. With his pet. Perfecto. Número dos. Ahora en el dos, lo que se ve ahí como están tres chicos. Como una reunión. ¿Qué estarán planeando? Ir a comer o ir al cine.
Déjeme ver, podríamos decir que son niños, no serán niños. Yo veo que son, o serán personas, serán niños.
Yo creo que son niños. The children the children's going to study the children going to study going to study English.
Podríamos decir, si es entonces pregunta, podríamos decir, are the children going to English class?
Are the children? Mm-hmm. ¿Qué más mencionó, perdón?
Are the children going to English class?
Perfecto.
¿Dónde está el verbo?
O podríamos...
Carlita y a Saúl.
Sorry.
Going to study.
Very good.
Going to study.
Y recuerden que children ya es plural, entonces ya no necesitan ponerle S.
No necesitamos, perdón.
Ponerle S a children, porque children ya es plural.
Ya.
Entonces, are the children, ¿verdad?
Sí, going es. To study uh-huh. English class.
Excellent, yes.
Perfecto.
Y podríamos decir, the next year.
Are the children going to study English next year? Uh-huh.
The next year.
Omita el da, next year, solo next year.
Next year.
Okay.
Next year. Perfecto. Número 3. Ese como que es un pedazo de pizza, ¿verdad? El 9.
I think so.
Sí.
Mary. Mary, is Mary going to eat pizza with your friends?
Sería with her friends.
A ver, ¿cómo quedaría? Dijimos.
Is Mary going to eat pizza with her friends?
Is Mary going to eat pizza with their friend, ¿verdad? With their friends.
With her friend,
¿verdad?
Porque es
con ella, los amigos.
Sí, exacto.
With her friends. Perfecto. Mm-hmm. With her friends.
Y está bien que agreguemos, para hacerlo un poco más largo, así como usted lo dice, que no sea muy como sí. Fácil, ¿verdad? Podríamos agregar at the party.
Is Mary going to eat pizza with her friends at the party? Perfecto.
At the party. At the party. Bueno, vamos a la última ahorita, a la última pregunta.
Se refiere al cine, supongo. Movie night.
Movie night.
Palomitas y
tickets,
¿verdad? Movie
night.
Qué genial.
Movie night. Mm-hmm. Y veamos.
Estamos en preguntas, ¿verdad?
Sí, preguntas, sí.
Podría ser... Are you going to go to the cinema?
Are you going
weekend?
Are you going?
Uh-huh. O podríamos decir miércoles, ¿verdad? Miércoles de promo. Are you going to the cinema?
Are you going to the cinema?
The next Wednesday.
Next Wednesday.
Oh, next Wednesday, teacher. Next, without the. Okay.
Perfect. Very good. No the. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Next Wednesday. Muy bien. Bueno, ahí terminamos la primera parte, digamos. Y ahora veamos la segunda parte.
Uh-huh.
En la segunda parte, la primera pregunta no la copié. No logré copiar la primera pregunta.
Se la comparto ahorita, Saúl.
Sí, veamos.
¿This one, Saúl?
Perdón, ahorita. Uh-huh. Ahorita, en este momento, veamos. Thank you, teacher.
You are welcome.
Muy bien, aquí no vamos a escribir nada, ¿verdad? Simplemente le voy a hacer la pregunta, Carlita.
That's right, very good. Okay. Saúl, usted le hace la... Ajá, exacto. Perdón. Sigan.
Sí. What time are you going to go to the bed tonight?
I'm going to bed at 11 p.m.
Carlita, I'm going to bed or I'm going to go to bed?
I'm going to go to the bed at okay. 11 p.m.
All right. Excellent. Okay.
Excellent. Number two. What time are you going to get up tomorrow?
I'm going to get up tomorrow at 4 a.m.
Repeat, please.
Okay. It's sad. I know it. It's sad.
Yeah, you know, when antes que empezara todo esto del COVID, igual, I used to wake up at 4:30. Créame que no lo extraño.
No, qué terrible. Okay, entonces sería la respuesta. I'm going to get up tomorrow at 4 a.m.
Excellent. Number three. What are you going to do after class?
I'm going to brush my teeth.
I'm going to
brush my teeth.
Ahí no entendí.
Ah, voy a lavar mis dientes.
Ah, excelente.
Yo voy a lavarme los dientes.
Excelente. Number four. What are you going to do tomorrow morning?
I'm going to go to my work.
I am going to go to my work. Ah, excellent. Number five. Where are you going to go on the weekend?
I am going to go to my work.
Carlita, oh no, Carlita.
I don't have another answer.
All right, that's okay. No, that's fine.
Number six. How much money are you going to spend tomorrow?
I'm going to spend $4.
Excellent. Excelente. Ahí terminamos, teacher.
Ahora le hago las preguntas.
Solo Carlita le hace las preguntas a Saúl ahora, sí.
Ok. Perfecto. Ok, Saúl, what time are you going to go to bed tonight?
I am going to go to bed. I am going to go to bed 12 o'clock, because I am going to go to the park.
Yes. Nice.
Really, Saúl?
Yes.
Okay, very nice. Let's okay. Ah, very nice, Saúl. Okay.
Okay, hey, Saúl, what time are you going to get up tomorrow?
Saúl, Carlita, Saúl.
Sorry.
What happened, Carla?
¿Y qué dije, teacher? Perdóneme.
Saúl, creo que dijo.
Ay, qué momento. Sorry. Ay, no.
I am going to get up tomorrow at 5 a.m.
Okay. What are you going to do after class?
I am going to go to the park.
Okay. And what are you going to... Estamos en la número 4, ¿verdad?
Sí.
What are you going to do tomorrow morning?
I am going to work. ¿Cómo quedaría ahí?
I'm going to go to work.
I am going to go to work. Muy bien.
Okay, Saúl, where are you going to go on the weekend?
I am going to go to visit my family.
Nice. And how much money are you going to spend tomorrow?
I am going to spend ten dollars.
Okay.
Perfect. Guys. Very nice. Thank you. So you finished everything, yes?
Yes, teacher.
All right, very good. We're gonna go back to the main group para ver to see how your classmates are doing. Okay, thank you.
Okay, teacher.
All right, guys, very good. Did you finish? Were you able to finish all your sentences, negative, affirmative, and questions? And did you practice asking and answering your questions?
Yes, teacher.
Excellent. Very good. Good. All right. Very nice. I know some of you finished before, but there are some other groups that they finish later, all right? So I was just working with two groups, so they were working on that right now. Very good, let's see. So here, I'm gonna share this with you. So for number one, let me see, Carlita, Carla and Saúl, what was your sentence for the clock? Tell me your sentence, no importa si fue pregunta, negative or affirmative, usted hágala.
Perfecto. I am going to eat tomorrow morning at 6 o'clock.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Very nice. Francisco Javier, number two. ¿Con quién estaba? Who were you working with, Francisco Javier? Your microphone, Francisco.
Fabiola.
Ah, okay, very good. So tell me your sentence, Francisco and Fabiola. Uh-huh.
Okay. ¿Qué es el café, verdad?
The cup of coffee, yes.
Cup of coffee is okay. Where are you going to drink a cup of coffee with me?
Okay, very good, interesting, very nice. Number three, Andres Giovanni, who were you working with?
With Jennifer Magali.
Oh, okay. Very good. So tell us. Uh-huh.
Number three is, where is she going to swim the next Monday?
Mm. Where? Where is she going to swim next Monday?
Yeah.
All right. Very good. Nice. Thank you. Let me see. Elcita and Mariela, number four.
What are you going to eat the breakfast?
What are you going to eat for breakfast? For breakfast. What are you going to eat for breakfast? Very good. Okay. Thank you. Yeah, nice. Noemi, number five. Who are you working with, Noemi? Noe?
With me.
Ah, okay, Juan Francisco, tell us sentence number five.
Who is going to fix the computer?
Excellent. Who is going to fix the computer? Very nice. All right. Thank you. You see, number six, Werner. Aha, Werner. Who were you working with? Werner with Edgar? No.
Just teachers, yes, con,
okay.
Con
Edgar. All right, very good. So tell us sentence number six.
Espérame, teacher, la ando buscando.
What
happened? Se me ha perdido. Se me ha perdido, es que no sé dónde la anoté.
Qué barbaridad.
Are you going to bookstore today?
¿Otra vez, Werner?
You are going to bookstore.
You're going to bookstore. Pero ¿cuál sería el verbo, Werner?
El verbo. No sería. Sería. Take. No, pero. No, ¿cómo es? ¿Cómo sería? Espérame, teacher. Fred, going to battle. Bueno, no lo tengo, teacher, pero el verbo en este caso sería como comprar, irás a comprar, tendría que ser.
Ok, buy, ok.
Sí, buy, sí. Buy. Sí, you are going to buy bookstore today.
You are going to buy.
¿La librería entera? ¿O un libro a la librería?
Un libro, teacher.
Ay, bueno, también tiene mucho dinero.
Pero lo que pasa es que irás a la librería. Irás a la librería, no especifica qué, o sea, irás a comprar.
Ok, are you going to, pero tiene que decir, are you going to go, are you going to buy something at the bookstore?
Okay, that's okay,
very good, Werner, that's nice. Let's see, number seven, a ver, let me see. Juan Francisco, number seven.
She is going to go with your dog at the park.
¿Con mi perro o con el perro, Juan Francisco?
Oh, my dog.
¿Con el suyo o con el de él?
No, es que she is going to go with her dog.
Her dog.
Ah, espérame, el principio decía she or he.
She.
Ah, perdón, o sea, she is going to go with her dog. Muy bien, very good, nice, thank you.
Thank you.
Let me see. Mariela, can you tell us sentence number eight?
Number eight. they are not going to school this year.
¿Cuál es el verbo, Mariela?
No, le faltó go.
Ay, lo siento. They are not going to go to school this year.
Excellent. They are not going to go to school this year. Excellent. Nice. Okay. Number nine, Carla.
Okay. Is Mary going to eat pizza with her friends at the party?
Excellent. Very nice. All right. Very good. Fabiola, number 10. Fabi? Fabi, Fabi, aló, aló.
La 10 no, no la noté.
Ok. ¿Pero qué se le puede ocurrir, Fabi, con la número 10? A ver, solo viendo la imagen.
Preguntas, ¿no?
Cualquiera, ya. Ah, ok, 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 ajá.
Why are you going to cinema?
Uh-huh. So you say, are you going to go to the cinema, maybe? All right. Are you going to go to the cinema on Saturday or Wednesday or whenever, right? Very good. Okay. Then we have these guys here. I'm just gonna show you this. All right, let's see. Francisco Javier, what time are you going to go to bed tonight?
Sorry, teacher.
Yes, that's okay.
Okay, what time are we going to go to bed? Okay, I'm going to the bed at 12 a.m.
Okay, all right, very good. Edgar, Alfredo, what time are you going to get up tomorrow? Hi, Edgar.
I'm going to get up. Uh-huh. I'm going to get up 5 o'clock.
I'm going to get up at 5 o'clock. All right, nice.
At 5 o'clock.
Yes, very good. Okay. Thank you.
Yeah.
All right, let's see. Elsie, what are you going to do after class?
I'm going to the after class. I sleep.
Okay, so I'm going to go to bed after class. All right, very good. I'm going to go to sleep after class. Very good. Yes. Noemi, what are you going to do tomorrow morning?
I'm going to go work.
I'm going to go to work. Very good. I'm going to go to work. Very nice. Let me see. Magali, where are you going to go on the weekend?
I'm going to go to the park.
All right, nice. And Werner, how much money are you going to spend tomorrow? Werner?
Yes, teacher.
Number six, how much money are you going to spend tomorrow?
No sé, teacher, esa no la hice.
All right.
He is going to spend many money.
Much money. All right, he's going to spend much money. All right, very good. It depends how much he's going to spend, right? Very good, thank you. Okay, let's continue, guys, here with this. Let's go back to your book. All right, so we have this. We're not going to do this here. We're going to go back to page 42. How to use be going to, all right? So we have, look at the words in bold and complete the sentence. Affirmative sentences, so ya lo vimos, I'm going to arrive on Friday 14th. I'm going to stay until Monday. Miss Puentes is going to travel to Costa Rica on April 14th. All right, negative sentences. Miss Puentes is not going to fly to Cuba on the 14th. Mr. Gomez is not going to arrive on Thursday 13th. All right, so affirmative, negative. Then we have the yes, no questions. Are you going to stay in a smoking or non-smoking room? Aquí acuérdese que usted va a contestar con yes I am, or no I'm not, or yes he is, or no he's not, or yes we are, or no we're not, depende de quién. Are you going to make the reservation for a single or a double room? Luego tenemos las information questions, que son lo que estamos haciendo ahorita en la práctica. Information questions, how long are you going to stay? When are you going to arrive? All right? Use be going to plus verb, base form, to describe schedule activities and activities that will definitely happen in the future. For negative sentences, insert not before going to. All right? Entonces acá igual lo que estábamos viendo, cuando tenemos certeza de algo, algo que ya está planeado o está establecido dentro de un horario porque ya lo planeamos, all right? Y para hacer oraciones negativas ponemos not. To ask yes, no questions about schedule activity, begin with the verb be, plus the subject, plus going to, plus the verb.
Pero eso va para los...
For information questions, just place the WH word, phrase, at the beginning of the questions and continue like you would to do for a yes, no question. A ver, tenemos estas oraciones, la uno ya está hecha para ustedes, la dos... 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6 en lo que resta de clase, y nos vamos a quedar aquí. Vamos a ordenar las oraciones, all right? En este caso, me parece, no todas son preguntas. Si es pregunta, pues obviamente tenemos el signo. Si no, es negativa or affirmative sentence. The number one, it says, when are you going to arrive to Dallas, all right? Porque ordenamos esto de aquí. Orden en number 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, all right? Tenemos un ratito para hacerlo. Me avisan cuando terminen para revisarla.
Ok.
Te vas a dormir.
Oh, okay.
All right, guys, let's see. Edgar, can you do number two, please? Are a reservation that you going to for conference room make?
What?
For number two?
Number two, sorry. Sorry, number two. When are you going to make a reservation for the
A ver, Edgar, for number two.
Teacher.
Hola, hola, me escucha.
When are you? Sí, sí. All right. Igualmente, sí, le escucho.
Okay.
Le decía la number two. When are you going to make a reservation for the conference room?
Edgarcito, disculpe, yo no veo when ahí. ¿O soy yo, niños? Ayúdenme ahí. ¿No, verdad?
Ah, perdón. No.
All right. ¿Cómo nos quedaría entonces? Pero, solo quite
sí,
el when.
Entonces, sí. Sí, es que yo la hice como pregunta. Pero ajá. Sí le agregué el when, tiene razón.
Ok, all right.
Ajá. Entonces all right. Sería... You are going to make a reservation for the conference room.
Right, very good. Okay, nice. Magali, thank you. Magali, number three.
I'm going to wake up call at 5 a.m. for request.
No, Magali. I'm going to, ahí vamos bien. I'm going to, luego necesito un verbo. No.
Request.
Ajá, I'm going to request. For?
For 5 a.m. No. For 5 a.m. wake up call.
I'm going to request for a wake up call at 5 a.m.
Okay.
Yeah, ahí de hecho le hace falta at. I'm going to request for a wake-up call at 5 a.m. Le hace falta el at ahí. Very good. A ver, Juan Francisco, number four.
Four. Mr. Turcios is going to check out tomorrow.
Yeah. Mr. Turcios is going to check out tomorrow. Very good. Elsie, what do you have for number five? And then Carla, you are going to do number six.
My tenants team is going to attend the conference on October 10th.
Good. Thank you. All right. And Carla, can you do number six?
Hey, teacher. Miss Diaz is going to need a non-smoking room.
Perfect. Very good. Thank you. All right, guys. Very good. Well done. So here, I'm gonna take the last attendance so you can go and rest. Andrés Giovanni Valdivieso Portillo.
Present, teacher.
Soyla Noemí Córdoba de Valencia.
Present.
Yamileto Osorio Alfaro. Candelaria del Tránsito Martínez Cisneros. Edgar Alfredo Mengíbar Pineda.
Present, teacher.
Carla Marta Cano Rivas.
Here.
Mayra Yasmín Rodríguez García. Mayra, Marvel Omar Ramírez Vázquez. Fabiola Georgina Silva.
Present, teacher.
Juan Francisco Enríquez González.
Present, teacher.
Elsie Anet de María Ramírez Navarro.
Present, teacher.
Marcos Giovanni Morán Flores. Werner Mauricio Reyes Ángel.
Present, teacher.
Jennifer Magali Morales Guzmán.
Present.
Carlos Jonathan García Alvarado. Jorge Antonio Hernández Cruz. Francisco Javier Villatoro Canales.
Present.
Mariela Los Ángeles Alvarado Díaz.
Present.
And José Saúl González Roque.
Present, teacher.
Excellent, guys. Very good. All right. So I will see you guys tomorrow. Thank you so much for being with me another night. Three more nights and we finish, guys. Okay. Please, please work on your platform on homework 17. All right. Thank you, guys. I'll see you tomorrow. Have a great night. Bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, teacher. See you tomorrow.
See you tomorrow.